signal t2 when I is equal to 0 and t3 when I equal to 1. Here these are the memory reference instruction. D0 indicates A and D and D1 indicates add instruction. D2 indicates LDA and D3 indicates store accumulator, load accumulator, store accumulator, branch unconditionally, branch save return 0 and branch save return address and branch and ISZ increment skip if 0, increment skip if 0, right? A and default decoder operation is D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 like this. Here this is a very very important the memory reference instruction separate topic is there, so that observe clearly this is the memory reference instructions. So very very important actions here. This is a little bit concentration required in this case for understanding, so I will explain clearly. See first one, end operation, the decoder operation is 0. See here, accumulator, this is the end operator, ended with memory of address. From the memory, operand is readed, that operand is ended with accumulator data. That means these are the two inputs. These two inputs, end operation is performed. So with the help of these two inputs, we are going to perform end operation. After end operation, what is the end operation? That means any input is 0, the output is 0. That result, the complete result is stored into the accumulator, where arrow indicates the direction of data flow. That means the result is stored into the accumulator, ADD. AD means, ADD action means accumulator input data is added with memory of address register. Memory of address means, M means memory, address means register, brackets means memory. Inside memory, address values is pointed by one location. That location has some byte of information or word of information available. That word is, that operand word, complete data is added with accumulator. This the total result, addition result will stored into the accumulator. Load accumulator, memory of address pointed by one location, that location data is stored in accumulator. Store accumulator, accumulator register data is stored into the memory location, inside memory locations. Branching unconditionally, address register is stored into the PC. Automatically PC goes to one location, it will execute. PC goes to one particular location, the cursor will start the execution from that instruction only. Save return address and branching. Save return address and branching means PC, it is already pointed one address, that is return address is saved in the memory location. Okay, again address register is incremented by 1. Address register is incremented by 1. Again that address is stored into the PC. Again it points to the branching address. In this case PC is stored into the memory of address register. This is the save return address. So next, PC address register is incremented by 1, it points to the address of the next instruction. So that here branching and save return address, first it will perform the save return action, next it will perform the branching action. So increment skip if 0, increment and skip if 0. Here increment skip if 0 means the memory of address register data, memory of address register location data is added with 1. The data incremented by 1, that again that result is stored into the memory of address register, same location. So if memory of address register data plus 1 is equal to 0, after incrementation if it is goes to 0, if it is 0, then it skips and it points to, it skips and it points to the address of the next instruction. Increment skip if it is 0. After incrementation it checks whether it is 0 or not. If it is 0, then it skips the current instruction, it points to address of the next instruction. This is the way we are going to observing, this is observing individual operations. So same action will be implemented here with the, suppose is there any doubt regarding with decoder and timing pulses T4 and D0, N2AC pairwise, and two bits in AC and the memory word specified by the effective address. Here D0 and T4, D0 means 000, triple zero means the first decoder. Here end to AC means end operation. D0 indicates here end. T4 is the T4 cycle, that particular reaction will be implemented. What will happen in T0? T0 instruction is readed. T2, that instruction is readed into the IR register, PC is incremented. Previously we have seen like this. This is a T0, T1, T2. PC is stored into address register, memory of address register is T1 action, PC is incremented, that instruction register is decoded by like this, T0, T1, T3. And T3, it will decide which type of instruction, either register reference, memory reference or IO reference. And T4, that particular action will be executed, that particular action will be executed. So that D0 indicates end operation in T4, and the end mnemonic, end decode mnemonic will be generated by the processor, that particular reaction will be implemented. Memory of, after, see here, T4, memory of address register, data will be readed into the data register, and D0, same end operation, T5 cycles, that particular operation will be implemented. Because here, memory of address, data is read into the data register. Data register is ended with accumulator. That accumulator value will store into the accumulator. So after execution, T5 cycle, sequence counter goes to 0. Same as it is like this. In the T4 cycle, T0, T1, T2, it reads and it decodes up to T3 is decoded. Memory of data, memory of address, data will read in data register. Accumulator data register is added in T5 cycle. Again, that result will show into AC. At this time, if is there any carry generated, that carry output is stored into the E field. That means E means extended accumulator. See, that time sequence counter goes to 0 because it starts, it reads one more instruction from the memory. Like this, load, LDA, load in the sense memory of address register is data T4, T5 action is there, that data register is loaded into the AC, memory to data register, data register to AC. Here D3, so LDA means D2, STA means D3, here ADD means D1, T4, T4 actions are same as it is, T4 only store accumulator, so accumulator to direct memory, sequence counter equal to 0, branch unconditionally, address register goes to PC and sequence counter is cleared. D4, D5, because branching is a D4 decoded instruction. Branch and save return address. PC goes to memory of address register, save return address first, address of the next instruction in sequence, the return address will be saved, and PC is address register plus increment, address is incremented. So this action will be implemented in block diagram. So this one, if it is understanding, okay. So if it is not understanding, we will see in the next block diagram. So it will give the clear indication. See here, example of branching and save return address instruction execution. So memory PC AR at a timing T4, this is the T5 execution, right? Initially 20 is the address, 21 is the address, 135 address, 136 address. This is the number of locations. This is the instruction execution. This is the subroutine program. As per this operation, this block is represented like this. This is the instruction. Zero field and this branch save return instruction. That means opcode. So this is the address. Address means 135. Automatically 135 is loaded address register. Address register goes to address register is there. Address register automatically it will sends to the PC. Address register value 135. PC means PC plus PC always incremented by 1. Subroutine program is there. Subroutine program is there. Next one. Subroutine, what is meant by subroutine? Actually 135 goes to this location. Again wait here 21 address. Next instruction 21 goes to memory of 135. Next instruction 135 memory of 135. See here. Okay, listen. Address register value is 20. That time PC is incremented by 121, right? While it is executing, program counter is incremented by 1. It is the pointing, just pointing purpose, next instruction execution purpose only, right? While it is executing, automatically this 135 address will stored into the address register. So that time this PC already hold 21 address. At that time, this PC is stored separate. PC is stored separate address, separate location. This address is stored in separate location. So where it is stored? So actually, cursor automatically it is changed to 135. But actual PC is pointed 21 instruction. As per sequence, after execution of this instruction, cursor goes to this instruction for the execution. But as per this instruction, the address the next execution is changed. So address value is 135. Automatically it is jumping from this instruction to this instruction. So already is PC value is 21. So that this 21 is stored into the another location, temporarily storage device. That means sometimes it is the save return address 21. 21 is the return address. Again, AR address value 135. AR value is 135, the PC value, same as AR value is 20, PC equal to next value. Here AR value is 135, PC is 136. So now the cursor starts from this instruction. So after execution of this instruction, the last instruction is like this. This is a zero field, which indicates direct address. 135 direct it is goes to this one. Address field PC is incremented by 1, so that it starts from this one. Same as it is branching 135 is the address, branching this is the 1 indirect way. So it finds where is the 135. This is the subroutine procedure. So after execution, this last instruction again sees from this location. 135 I field indicates indirect. So that means 135 is acts as a address. In this address, one more address value is available, that means 21. This 21 previously we are stored, right? This 21 is already stored. So 21 goes to this location. Again, it starts the execution from this instruction. So I will explain clearly once again. See here, branching and save return address, right? Here, save return address 21 is stored in memory of 135. Here action PC 135 plus 1 PC address means here. See here, this is the initially address register. So this is address register. Address register AR equal to 20. If address register value equal to 20, PC is automatically incremented by 1. Address register value is stored into the PC. PC is incremented by 1. So address register equal to 20 means this is currently to be executed in the ALU presently. While it is executing, the actual sequence of the program counter work is points to the address of the next instruction 21. Now it is PC value is 21, AR value is 20. So after execution, the automatically this label address will decide. So this is the memory reference instruction, so that 0 means direct address. Automatically cursor execution is changes. Actually, the cursor goes to next instruction for the processing, actual procedure. But this is the memory reference instruction. 135 is the new address. New address means AR address. Automatically AR will holds 135. Okay, so what about this PC? PC is a temporarily 21, previous it holds 21, this temporarily stored into the temporary address. Where is the AR register? 135, same location, this 21 is stored temporarily. Temporarily it will store 21, right? 21, see here, 21. So AR is 135, automatically PC work is plus 1 is always added. So again, it cursor, it starts from this program. Subroutine means this is a subprogram. Subroutine or subprogram or special program. It is executed by sequence by sequence. The cursor executing like this. Cursor is executing like this. And after executing, the last instruction is 1. 1 indicates, that means this is the indirect address. That means the address itself by itself, one more address is available. Branching 135. So after same information, subroutine is executing with the help of indirect address. I is equal to 1 field, 135 location is there. In that 135, previously temporarily return address is saved. That return address, again cursor goes to this location. 135 to this location, and this location to 21 is available. Again, previously it is skipped from this instruction. 135 direct it goes to this location, it executed. Again, it goes to this location and it holds the return address and it points next instruction, it executes the remaining instruction in the program. This is the way we are going to execute save return address and branching. Like this, branch, save return address, branching, instruction performs the function usually referred to as subroutine call. The indirect branching instruction at the end of the subroutine performs the function referred as the subroutine return. Most commercial computers, the return address associated with the subroutine is stored in either a processor register or in a portion of memory called a stack. So branch and save return address action will be performed like this. And increment skip if 0. Memory of address register is stored into the data register. Data register is incremented by 1. Again, it is stored into the data register. Again, data register value is stored into the memory of address register. Now it checks data register value. This one same. Now checks data register value equal to 0. If it is a skip if 0. So that if it is 0, then it is skipped. So that program counter is incremented by 1, sequence counter is goes to 0. Next. So here, individual actions, memory reference instruction, this is a flowchart. So end operation, add operation, LDA, STA, branching, branching save written address and increment skip if 0. So what are the actions we are going to perform? D0 and T4. What are the action? D0 and T5. What are the actions? D1, T4 actions, particular action, D1, T5 like this. We are represented in flowchart. Next one, input and input output and interrupt.